الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين واعتبروا بهداه إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد, we received a number of complaints, many complaints in fact, this year, last year, the year, the couple of years ago, in relation to sacrifices on the day of Eid. The nature of the complaints, of course, is the delays for long lines in the day of Eid, that people would mostly all go to this animal farms and for slaughterhouses around Montreal. And unfortunately, the numbers are very large for 1 day or 2 days or 3 days, even though they can, of course, distribute also up to 4 days. They can still continue to make their udhiyah, their sacrifices. The fact that the growers, the sheep growers in Quebec, they take advantage of the demand and the prices double around this time. And of course, that not only the sheep growers, everybody in the chain of services, from the growing sheep to delivering them to the slaughterhouse operators, to farmers, whoever, in the way they are making quite a bit of money more at the time of Eid, because of the fast demand. People want it, and in a specific time, in a specific period of time, and that of course makes it so. Also this year, we received some people proposing that we should boycott the sheep growers or sheep from Quebec, because that would send a message, because of the Charter of Rights or the proposed Charter of Rights. And the Muslim Council of Montreal adamantly and strongly recommend against those kind of ideas and this kind of language of using boycott or any such language within Quebec. Quebec is certainly our country, it's our city, and its economy is important for us. And this level of confrontation, we have not reached this position at all yet, and we hope we never get to visit this kind of an area. There's lots of ways to challenge the charter, and we have taken some steps, we're going to take some more, inshallah. So, a number of other complaints with the ministry in approval of this kind of outlets, and in the follow-up that they do those specific days around Muslims. They have said clearly that any individual living in Quebec has the right to slaughter his own animals, and for sports and otherwise, as long as they will do it themselves. But different municipalities, they have different rules, and you have to respect those rules, and you got to learn the rules in the municipality. And people should not really, I do not really recommend anyone would take this and do it at home. And I do not recommend that people would start, even though there's some arrangement at some of the mosques, Masjid al-Fath, I believe, or something like that, that they have made arrangement with the environment organizations, that they can collect all the remains of the sheep, the stomachs and different things, and that they can get rid of it in an environmental friendly ways, and so on. But I think we have to be very careful, because this kind of things will take, the focus will be on it in Eid, and it could be used by the media to malign and defame our community. Can also go against Islam, and unfortunately some Muslims themselves, they don't do the slaughtering in the proper way or in the merciful way that we have been told by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In whatever we do, that we have to do it in a good way, but unfortunately sometimes we go hide behind a wall and try to kill a sheep and try to this kind of ideas people get from time to time, and they think they are doing something good. This is certainly wrong, and also may not be healthy for the person, that those animals that they buy this way and they try to kill themselves without any observation and without any protection might be sick, and it would be very serious for them as well, so they have to be very careful with it. The government promised that they will send us the rules for the different municipalities in how to slaughter. We have not received those rules as yet. When we receive them, we'll certainly post them on our website at muslimcouncil.org, and we will try to also bring them to the attention of many of the mosques and the different organizations in the city. The sheep growers were rather not up to the level in the discussion. They have always been pointed that this is a market economy. It says it's the dynamics of the market that makes the price. But and we thought if this is the only way, the only answer to the increase of prices at that time would be the dynamics of the market, then might be we have to use that same market dynamics to fix the prices properly. Therefore, our decision for this year is while in fact slaughtering the sacrifices in the day of Eid is one of the best deeds, as Rasulullah said in the hadith, one can do, and to take 1/3 for yourself, 1/3 for your neighbors and relatives and friends, and 1/3 for the poor and the needy, that is certainly contribute to the well-being of the society where we live as well. But because of all those circumstances, there are different ways to do it. Some of them you would still keep it if you wish to do it in Quebec, but instead of sheep, you can go to cows. 7 people can get together and slaughter a cow divided by 7, and they can do the same thing, and they can have the same outlet. In fact, they will have more meat, because veal cow meat is much cheaper than the sheep or the lambs or whatever. So I think that would be a good idea. Normally, it's supposed to be 2 years of age for the cow, but there may be some flexibility because the size of the cow is reached much faster these days than 100 years ago, as they grow much faster, and by the way they feed them and so on. So we can check in some of these issues, inshallah, and find out the best way. But you can take the cow and you divide it by 7. And if you have more shares than, if you have 6, you will divide the cow, that's even the better. You have more shares than the Sharia, the Shara shares, that you have certain obligation. The minimum is 1/7 of a cow. So if you have more than 1/7 of a cow, all the better. And this all will be much cheaper than buying a sheep. Second, you can also, if you insist in eating sheep on Eid, lamb or whatever, you can also visit Ontario's auctions, and you can get at half the prices that you are getting in the market here. I heard some prices really very, very low, and some can really go directly to the auction and be able to buy some of this, or somebody can actually buy for a group of people quantities together, or there may be some outlets very soon that they can go and get them and that they can distribute as well. This takes place in Ottawa, takes place in Quebec City, and in some other places where you can actually buy directly. Third, you can buy directly, you can do it in Ontario altogether. You can get it slaughtered and done in Ontario and come delivered to you in a very nice and clean way at much lower price. The whole idea is the price. The control is really the price, so that you can send a message to the sheep growers in Quebec that their attitude is not going to really make it, and if they are not going to come down and try to work out with the community, then the community will find other means and ways to do it. Now, the key issue and the most important outlet that one can do this in would be rather in sharing with the Muslims around the world who are not in a good situation, not in a place or an environment that they can do that for themselves, or there is famine, or there are wars, or there are difficulties to even find food. You'll be very highly rewarded for this. You can do it in Syria, you can do it in Somalia, you can do it in Mali, you can do it in Burma, you can do it in Chechnya, you can do it in Kashmir, you can do it in Afghanistan, you can do it in Iraq, you can do it in Egypt, you can do it in any place that you know, you can do it in your own hometown for the needy who are there, directly, if you don't know, just send to your relatives and let them do it, and you get the shares of the relatives and the shares of the needy over there, and you can buy yourself local meat here at the low cost, anywhere, anytime. There is no problem with it. Ahead of time, you can even buy sheep if you wish, locally from the same people in Montreal, but ahead of time so that you can get it at much lower price, not in those 4 days, which it changes very rapidly. It goes up very fast in those days. I have seen it going up almost $1 a day just a month ago or 2 months ago. That was going like that. The price, it changes daily almost. You can also, we received also from Syria that the scholars, the Muslim scholars in Syria, have spoken about the fact that there is a disaster in Syria right now because of the war and the lack of feed for the animals. The animal growers actually have having issues, and there is quite a reduction in the number of heads that are being alive right now or growing right now in Syria, and they asked everybody not to slaughter this year. So they asked everyone not to slaughter this year at all, not to make udhiya this year in Syria to save the animals in general, not just sheep and cows, livestock. Yeah. And also they say even if they slaughter, or even if somebody send money in order for them to slaughter right in Syria, that meat would have to be eaten within very short period of time. They are not going to be able to save it because there is no electricity, and they do not have freezers to keep the meat for a long time so that they'll be able to provide it to others as food for a long time. So the best that they ask it, that people should send money, whatever money they were planning to use for the udhiya, is to send it directly to Syria so that it would be distributed for the needy and for refugees around in Syria and around the borders and so on, and it will help them more. Now I'm saying what they ask it. I'm not judging the action itself, but rather they are the people of Syria, and they know better about Syria than anyone else outside, and they know their needs, and the objective of Sharia in general is in fact the best benefit of people. So if they realize that this is would be much more beneficial to people, it will be much highly rewarded, maybe even more than performing the sacrifices itself, just to make sure that this money would go there and that they will take care of it. So find your way, check your, find the best possible way that fits your need, the one that you think is closer to your heart, and the one that is probably closer to your homes as well, and try to do it right there, or maybe even in 2-3 places, if especially when the prices are so low. I know in Pakistan, for example, which I did not mention, but there is earthquake there and there's still victims. And JFM, they have a program here, $85 the cow share. So this is very little, $85. If somebody takes one cow share there and one cow share in Syria, for example, if somebody from Pakistan and one sent to his own hometown and send another share to Syria, that would be alhamdulillah great. It's still less than one sheep here. That where they reach $500, you have 85, that's $170. You have done much better than any other place. And those that decide to do here, alhamdulillah, we still do not want the Sha'ar Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to stop. We do not want the udhiya to stop. So those who will do here, whether it's cows or lamb or sheep, continue to do, but try to avoid the outlets that it will increase the prices. And hopefully, with the united action from many Muslims, that by itself will reduce the pressure. And alhamdulillah, I know that many people are talking about it this year. So start, go on, and do it, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.